viewers, welcome to Limu TV, a station where you watch and learn. Today we're going to look at English Form 1, Lesson 1. I'll be your tutor, Hilary Stirit. Our topic today will be on writing, and the subtopic we're going to look at letters. So our lesson objective is that by the end of the lesson, you as a learner should be able to differentiate the different types of letters and to describe the different parts of a letter. And we'll begin at looking at the two main types of letters. We have the friendly letters or the informal. Friendly letters or the informal. We have the formal or the official letters. Those are the two main types of letters that we write. When we look at friendly letters, or you can, let's say first the following. In different letters, the format of the address will vary according to the type of letter written. The format of the address will vary according to the type of letter written. Although the addresses are written differently, they have some common features. When we talk of friendly letters, the letters that we write to our own friends, we write to family, our relatives, we write to our peers, we write to our age mates, and so on. And when we talk of formal or official letters, these are the letters that we write when we're looking for jobs, when you're looking for applying for a vacancy in different institutions, different companies. And so, we have the common features that appear in both letters. For instance, all the letters must have a box number. Another common feature is that all the letters must have a postcode, either to the sender or the receiver. Sender and the receiver. We also have must have the street, the road, building, or where the post office is located. All the letters must be sent maybe to a city, to a town, or a village, and also the country. Those are the common features that appear in both the friendly, the informal, and the formal letters. We can look at the format of letters. We must have the address of the sender, sender address, or the recipient address. It must have a date. It must have a salutation, valediction, name, body, and signing off. We're going to begin with the informal letters. And we can say they differ in terms of informality depending on whom the letter is addressed to. Steps to follow. You write the writer's address at the top right corner. You include the postal code. Below the address, write the date of and it should be in full. You skip a line and write the salutation on the left hand side. You start a new paragraph as you begin to write the body of the letter. Number 5, the language should be friendly and familiar. The language depends on the relationship between the writer and the person he is writing to. And in writing, the language must be easy to understand, decent and respectable, and it should be grammatical. At the end of your letter, sign off. The closing can be yours. You can use words such as yours lovingly, your affectionate, your classmate. And in writing the signing off, you say it depends with the relationship that you have with the sender. You also must have put your name below the closing tag, that's after signing. You punctuate your letter properly. At the end of the closing tag, there is a comma and a full stop that is put at the end. We can have a sample of a formal letter. We have the sender's address and the date, that's on the right side. On the left side, we have the receiver's address, salutation, subject or reason for writing the letter. Then we have the body. So when we talk of the formal letters, we say these are the letters which are sent, these are official letters which are sent maybe to companies, to schools, to institutions looking for a vacancy or a job. And we can see the sender's address on the right side. At the left side, we have the receiver's address, salutation, subject or reason for writing. And in the body, include what you are, the reason as to why you're writing your letter. And you can have your closing tag, signature, and the name. For instance, we have an example over there, Mwanga Secondary School, PO Box, date. On the right, we have the letter who is being addressed. We also have the box, we have salutation, and the re, which is To state the reason as to why is writing, launch of Junior Achievement Club. We also can see the body. And lastly, we can see signing off, yours faithfully, Bernadette Aporoko, Chair Lady. So I want you as a learner to write a letter to your friend in another school telling him or her about a recent trip you took. Then, that is will be on formal letter. And in the second one, you are in charge of the journalism club. Write to the editor of a local daily requesting him to talk on good journalistic practices. That will be our formal letter. If you want to refer more on letters, you can check them on Excelling in English, Students Book 1. We also have with page 73, third edition, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. And for this and much more on content, you can still SMS on the number posted over there, on YouTube at Elimu TV, on Facebook at Elimu TV, and on Twitter at Elimu TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson.